Good morning to all. In previous class, we discussed about that how can we separate that a mixture of two immiscible liquids, and how can we separate a mixture of salt and ammonium chloride. With the help of the diagram, we discussed these are the topics, how can we separate it. Now today we discussed about that how can we separate a mixture of color components, and then how can we separate a mixture of two miscible liquids, and how can we separate the mixture of more than two miscible liquids, and how can we obtain pure copper sulfate from an impure sample. These are the topic we discussed today. Okay, now how can we separate the mixture of color components by the help of chromatography. Here, what is that chromo means? That is, chroma means in Greek language, that is in Greek, chroma means color. Chroma means in Greek language color. Okay, so the name of that process to separate the mixture of color components is chromatography. Okay, now what is a chromatography? It is the technique used for separation of those solutes that dissolve in the same solvent. So that is called as a chromatography. Okay, it is the technique used for separating those solutes that dissolved in the same solvent. It means, say for example, you are take that so many colors to for any painting that any pictures. So you use that what a bowl or whatever you use it. In that bowl, what you take? Water. In a drawing box is there here. Watercolor box is there. In box, so many colors are there. Like this, different colors. Like this is red, yellow, and this is white, and this one is green, blue. Like this, different color having a that is color box is there, and a brush you use to color that picture. So what you do, always you dip that brush in this water. What happens, these are all the different colors which you dip in water to become wet, so that water become a colorful, totally different colors are mixed together. That different colors are mixing together, that's called as a solutes, and then that water is called as a solvents. There is a so many colors are mixed together, we cannot find out that which color is there. During that time, we can use to separate these which color are mixed together. Here we use the chromatograph. Let's say chromatograph is a just like a filter paper. So if we the tip of that filter paper, that's chromatography, we dipped here, so slowly it shows the different colors like this. This chromatography paper is like this. If we dip, slowly it appears different colors of the layers which is dipped into the which is present in this solution. Okay, this type of different colors are different layers are shown. So that is say example red, this appear, and orange, and here green and yellow. Like these, the different types of colors are shown in the strip of the chromatography. Thus we can separate it. Okay, now applications, where we used such applications, applications means where we applied, where we used it. That is to separate colors in the dye. Colors in a dye. Okay, in a dye, so many colors are present. That colors to separate, we use this chromatograph paper. Okay, second, to separate pigments from natural colors. From natural color. Say, for example, you see the different types of colors of flowers. Okay, in a flower, 2-3 colors are present in the flower petals. How can we separate it, that pigments, that colors, pigments means colors from the, by the help of this chromatograph paper. Okay, so that's we used there. And then drugs from blood, to separate that drugs from blood. So if drugs is present in some body, so to separate it, drugs from the blood, we use this technique, that is chromatograph technique. Okay, these are the applications. Okay, now we go to that topic, is how can we separate that a mixture of two miscible liquids, a mixture of two miscible liquids. Okay, miscible means which can be dissolved completely. In previous class we discussed about two immiscible liquids. Immiscible means which shows the two distinct different parts. In that technique, in that mixtures, we use the technique called as the separating funnel. Okay, but here we discussed about that miscible liquids. Miscible liquid means that two liquids are mixed together, which we cannot see in that which liquid is present in that compound, that is solutions. So at that time we use which technique? So we use the technique called as the distillation process. That is distillation process. Okay, how it is distillation process work? So by seeing this diagram we can easily explain it. Say, for example, it is a mixture of acetone and then water. It is a mixture of acetone and water. These are totally mixed together. How can we separate this acetone and then water? So we take this solution in a round bottom flask which connected to a delivery tube. Okay, and this is a rubber cork. The rubber cork is one hole rubber cork is this, and this from one hole rubber cork we put that a thermometer inside, that put with thermometer. Why we put that thermometer inside? Because both that liquids are present here, that is acetone and water. Both that mixtures having a different boiling points. By knowing that which one is fastly evaporates at a low temperature, so we use the thermometer to know that what's the temperature of that such a mixture. Okay, so next, this one is called as a delivery tube. In delivery tube, a jacket is present, water coolant jacket. Here with chilled water is poured into this jacket, and then this one is inlet, and then this one is a outlet. Here we put inside this very chilled cold water. Why we put that cold water? We discussed here after that explanation. Now whenever we explain it, this is the setup of this distillation. See here, first what we do here, we heat up this bottom flask by the help of the Bunsen burner. As that mixture is heat up, what happened? First acetone evaporates, because the acetone has a low melting point near about that 50 to 60 degrees Celsius. So 52 degrees, 50 to 60 degrees Celsius, the first acetone is evaporated, and that in the form of gas, it comes upwards and it passes into the delivery tube. At that time, a chilled water, means a cold, very cold water, is passed from that inlet. That gas become condenses. Condensed means that gas converted into a liquid form. Here, the cold water, that gaseous, converted into a liquid form. That's why it's called as a condensed. And we already discussed in that first chapter, that is condensation process. What is condensation process? The process in which the gaseous converted into water. So that is called as condensation. Here, condensed state is there, the acetone, which is gas form, converted into a liquid form. Then it finally, here we take in a beaker, and drop by drop that acetone is collected in a beaker. At the time that 52 degrees Celsius, we put that low flame, because the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. That during that 100 degrees Celsius, water is also get evaporates. That's why we are low flame we put of when it rises to 52 degrees Celsius. Thus, acetone can be separated by the water. This is that process is called as a distillation process. Okay. Now, I hope that you can understand easily. Once again, I explained it in Hindi. That is, ये mixture है acetone और water का. जैसे इसको heat करेंगे हम, यहाँ पे evaporate होने लग जाएगा. सबसे पहले acetone evaporate होगा. तो हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कि थर्मोमीटर हमने रखा है यहाँ पे, थर्मोमीटर फिट करा है इसके अंदर, 50 टू 60 डिग्री सेल्सियस आते ही एसीटोन इवेपरेट होने लग जाता है. उस टाइम में हम लो फ्लेम कर देते हैं, क्योंकि एसीटोन इवेपरेट होने लग गया तो वो एसीटोन गैसेस से लिक्विड में बदलेगा. क्यों लिक्विड में बदल जाएगा? यहाँ पे कोल्ड वाटर होता है ना, इस डिलीवरी ट्यूब को जैसे कोल्ड वाटर टच होगा, ये लिक्विड में बदल देता है. कंडेंसेशन प्रोसेस हो जाता है यहाँ पे. तो जैसे यहाँ पे हम अलग से एक बीकर रखेंगे, तो ड्रॉप बाय ड्रॉप एसीटोन कलेक्ट कर लेंगे लो फ्लेम में. जैसे जैसे एसीटोन कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा लिक्विड में यहाँ पे, और कलेक्ट करेंगे, और एसीटोन अलग हो जाएगा, यहाँ पे वाटर अलग हो जाएगा. सो ये प्रोसेस को हम बोलते हैं डिस्टिलेशन प्रोसेस. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी गो टू दैट हाउ वी सेपरेट द मिक्सचर ऑफ टू मोर देन टू मिसिबल लिक्विड्स. ओके, मोर देन टू, ये तो टू मिसिबल लिक्विड्स है. मोर देन टू मिसिबल लिक्विड्स में, मोर देन टू मिसिबल लिक्विड्स में वी यूज द फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन यूज में लेते हैं. फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन है, दो से ज़्यादा मिक्सचर मिक्स हो चुका है, उसको सेपरेट कैसे किया जाता है, तो उसमें फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल क्रूड ऑयल, क्रूड ऑयल मीन्स पेट्रोलियम. उस पेट्रोलियम में क्या क्या प्रेजेंट है? पेट्रोल प्रेजेंट है, डीजल प्रेजेंट है, केरोसिन प्रेजेंट है, नेचुरल गैस प्रेजेंट है, पैराफिन वैक्स प्रेजेंट है. इसमें से बहुत सारे मिक्सचर्स प्रेजेंट है उस क्रूड ऑयल के अंदर. उसमें हम यूज करते हैं जो प्रोसेस है फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन. इसमें देखो, ये मिक्सचर्स को ले लेते हैं, इसमें बहुत सारे मिक्स है. से इसको क्रूड ऑयल ही मान लो, कि इसके अंदर जैसे पेट्रोल है, डीजल है, इन सब का भी अलग अलग बॉइलिंग पॉइंट्स होता है. हम इसको बॉइलिंग जैसे करेंगे यहाँ पे, ये इसके अंदर ये थर्मामीटर सेट करते हैं. जैसे हीट होगा, जो सबसे कम जिसका बॉइलिंग पॉइंट होगा वो पहले इवेपरेट होगा. वो इवेपरेट होके यहाँ मार्बल्स होता है इसके अंदर, वो मार्बल से पास होते हुए इस डिलीवरी ट्यूब में आएगा गैसेस. इस डिलीवरी ट्यूब में अगेन हम क्या करेंगे, कोल्ड वाटर, इसमें वेरी कोल्ड वाटर इसमें पास करेंगे इनलेट के थ्रू या आउटलेट के बाहर आ जाएगा। तो ये गैशियस फॉर्म में क्या किस में चेंजेस हो जाएगा, लिक्विड फॉर्म में चेंजेस होके अलग से कलेक्ट कर लेंगे। सो ये कलेक्ट होते ही दूसरा रखेंगे हम यहाँ पे, क्योंकि दूसरा मिक्सचर थोड़ा और भी हीट करते जाएंगे तो धीरे धीरे दूसरा मिक्सचर इवेपरेट होने लग जाएगा। जैसे दूसरा इवेपरेट होने लगेगा तो दूसरा ऐसे ही गैसेस से लिक्विड में कन्वर्ट होगा कंडेंसेशन स्टेट में, और दूसरा बीकर यहाँ पर रखेंगे तो वो अलग से कलेक्ट होता जाएगा। इस तरह से बहुत सारे मिक्सचर्स कोई भी हो जाता है तो उसको हम अलग करते हैं बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन। सो इसमें इम्पॉर्टेंट क्या है रोल, ये बीट्स है ना, ये बीट्स यानी मार्बल्स, जैसे मार्बल दिख रहा है इसमें, इसका रोल क्या है, इसका रोल है देखो यहाँ, द बीट्स प्रोवाइड सरफेस फॉर द वेपर्स टू कूल एंड कंडेंसेस रिपीटेडली। इसमें क्या करता है बीट्स, इट्स प्रोवाइड सरफेस फॉर द वेपर्स, वेपर्स को जाने के लिए सरफेस देता है टू कूल एंड कंडेंस रिपीटेडली। यहाँ पे कूल होने के लिए, यहाँ पे इसमें जाने के लिए, वेपर्स को जाने के लिए हेल्प करता है ये मार्बल्स, बाकी का तो हम अंदर ही रहता है दूसरा मिक्सचर, ये बाहर जाने के लिए सरफेस एरिया देता है। सो वेपर्स में यहाँ आकर वाटर में, मतलब जो कोल्ड वाटर इसमें लिक्विड में बदल देगा उस मिक्स, जो वेपर में आया जो जो भी कंपोनेंट आया जो, वो अलग से हो जाएगा कंप्लीट। ओके, दिस इज फ्रैक्शनल डिस्टिलेशन प्रोसेस। ओके, फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दैट हाउ कैन वी सेपरेट दैट कॉपर सल्फेट, ओके, फ्रॉम प्योर फ्रॉम कॉपर, ओके, कॉपर सल्फेट सॉल्यूशंस कॉपर से कैसे अलग करेंगे फिर। ओके, थैंक यू।